So, what does 2 weeks of user design made by a programmer look like? Stay tuned and find out after the intro. Hey everyone and welcome to another episode. I'm Ombarus, and if you're new to my channel, I'm a programmer with about 10 years of experience making mobile games in the industry, and I decided that I wanted to start doing it as an indie developer making my own game, and so I started this YouTube channel as a way to do some show and tell so that you can see the process of developing your own game, but also so that you can use some of the techniques and methods I'm using into your own projects, and hoping that you will learn something from my videos. I think, as a programmer, I understand usability better than most programmers. And I've been on both sides of the fence. I've seen bad, frustrating user experience, and I could tell where they came from, because you see, most programmers, they have to juggle a lot of different things, you know, good design architecture, beautiful code, reusability, compatibility, and all these kind of things can often be at odds with a good user interface. And that's why I believe that you should design your code from the top down, meaning that you should first design the UI, decide where everything should be and how the interaction should be done, and then have it, you know, proofed read by some people, and then when you're sure that you have a good design, then you make the code under it fit that design, even if sometimes it means that you have to do some ugly patching of your code to manage to get the UI work the way you want. I think it's very important in the end to get a good design and a good usability and a user that will enjoy playing your game. Ironically, 2 weeks ago, I got people to play my game. I reached out on Reddit and Discord, and I reached out to my friends on Facebook and stuff like that. And the feedback I got was that the usability was bad, really bad. So what did I do? Well, I spent the last 2 weeks looking at my game from a user perspective, and I used all the feedback I got, and I started writing down all the issues I had. And I wrote down every single little detail I could. And then I started looking at all of these and organizing them in categories. And what I came up with is that there was basically 3 or 4 menus in my game that were just really, really bad and really impeded the flow of the game. So I went in and I started trying to redesign all of these UI. The first one I did was the inventory, because it was one of the most simple ones. This is what the inventory looked like before, and this is what the inventory looks like now. And before, you had to go into a separate menu to change your equipment, but now, like in most normal games, the equipping and unequipping of items is now in the same menu. You can use drag and drop buttons, show and hide based on what you have selected. So if you can use an item, the use button is going to show up, and all of this is now working. The second dialog I went for after the inventory is the transfer window. See, in my game, you can transfer item from one ship to another, so I needed a way to basically display 2 inventory side by side. And the mockup I had for that was kind of functional, but really ugly. It's kind of works, but you know, it's kind of hard to understand, and it looks like a prototype of some kind of weird thing. So now I try to clean that up, add icons, add menus, and also unify the look to be like the new inventory I did. And so now it looks kind of something like this. And so you have all the equipment of one ship on one side and all the equipment of one ship on the other side, and you have buttons in the middle to move things in between. Of course, also you can use drag and drop to make it even easier, and everything just flows so much easier. So the last one was actually the biggest issue I had from all the feedback I got. Actually, a lot of people who tried my game couldn't get past the first level just because they couldn't figure it out, and that's the converter dialog. The converter dialog is kind of like the crafting in my game, so you basically have a list of items you can craft, and then you have to select what item in your inventory you're going to use to craft this recipe. So you select the recipe, you select the crafting ingredients, and then you should be able to craft whatever you need to craft. But most people couldn't figure it out, and it was quite a big challenge to make everything fit in one screen. The first design I had, you can see here, first of all, you couldn't even figure out that there was multiple lists in there because the screen was just black, but also it was a bit of a mess. Some lists were gray, some lists were black, the buttons would disappear and appear, and some information was kind of hidden from you, like you didn't know that producing something would take turns. So now everything is much clearer, you have information, you even have information about your ship, so that if you're producing something and the ship comes behind you while you're producing stuff, you'll know that you're getting attacked because you'll see, and also you'll see how much energy you have left to make sure that you can produce stuff. You don't have to go back and forth between the window and the status bar on the HUD. And all of this, I think, makes it much more usable. But I didn't get to that point without some effort. So beside making a whole list of things that needs to be fixed, I also had to find a design that I liked. For this, I went online and I started looking at different games and how they do their stuff. And it's a bit tricky. I wanted a user interface that could be used on PC, but that is also friendly for mobile game. And I'm thinking maybe I'm gonna have to make two different UI for this, but for now I need something that you can use on both sides. And to do that, I went and I looked at online games, I looked at, you know, even AAA games like Fallout and stuff like that, and I knew I wanted my game to be more text heavy. I know nowadays the design philosophy is that everything should be icons. I don't really like it, this is a personal choice, but it guided the way I was going for in my design. And so after finding a couple of different examples where text is used instead of icon and how they're arranged, I found a look that I kind of liked and I tried to adapt it into what I needed for my game. To do that, what I did is that basically I started making a whole lot of drawings. And as you can see, I went to quite a lot of iteration. These are designed for my transfer windows. And then I have designs here for my inventory. These are all separate designs with little notes I made of what was working, what wasn't working, what I liked about this design, what I didn't like, sometimes writing like the name, where it came from, what game it came from. And it wasn't over, I kept going. There's more and more and more and more. And these iterations are really fast. That's why I'm doing them on paper, because it's just to do them really quick. But I didn't start implementing all of this right away. No. After this first drawing part on the paper, I went in and I started Godot, but I didn't start my real project. I first created an empty scene where I started mucking up what I had in mind, what I had drawn on paper, but without having to implement it actually in my code. Because like I said at the beginning, making it work with your code sometimes can involve a lot of headaches, and I don't want this to affect the design of my UI. I want to make sure the UI is designed for the user first and not for the code. So what I did is I created this mockup folder and I started making mockups of just what I wanted the UI to look like. So for example, this is the mockup of the inventory I did. As you can see, the lists are populated with just bogus stuff, just to help me figure out if the look is fine, if the buttons look right. And the fact that there's no code also means that I can run this scene as a standalone and I can have a look at it, I can kind of interact with it, though it's not an actual list, so it's not going to do anything if I click the buttons, but it still gives me kind of an idea of what the final product would look like. And once I was happy with this, then I started taking some of the elements, like these rows here, I started saving them as an external, and then I started creating a whole new scene. I didn't even start from that scene to implement the code, I just started a whole new scene, but this time I started by integrating some of my components for making lists, and then some of my controls and some of my stuff. I think it's really nice, and it flows much better than the original version I had. Plus, I could reuse a lot of stuff from the original version, so it's not like I had to recode the whole thing. I did a lot of copy-paste. And then once I was finished, I just deleted the old version, because after all, I'm using GitHub, so even if I delete it, I can still recover it from previous version, so I'd rather not pollute the code base, I'll just delete it, and if I need to refer to it, I can go check it out in GitHub. But for now, my scene, my project is much cleaner, and I don't have any old obsolete stuff lying around. I could delete all the GD script, all the old stuff, all the old scene. And now I have a much better looking, much better usable interface. There's still quite a lot of things I need to work on and a lot of little things that makes the game not so user-friendly. But I think right now it doesn't look too bad. So I'm happy with it. And you guys on YouTube are the first one to have a look at the new interface. So let me know what you think. Let me know in the comments if you think I've improved it or butchered it. And that's going to be it for this week. So see you guys in my next episode. Bye. Oh yeah. And don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and check out my Patreon page if you want to maybe support me. That would be really awesome.